Want to know how we're literally sending thousands of cold emails every single day for our company and landing in the inbox of our lead 80% of the time? Getting in your lead's main inbox 80% of the time leads to higher opens, which higher opens leads to higher appointments. Higher appointments leads to higher sales. Higher sales leads to, well, you could guess it, more money for you, your team, your family, your impact, whatever else you want. What's going on, everyone? I'm Ravi Abouvala here, founder of Scaling With Systems. And in this video, I'm gonna show you the top four techniques you need to follow in order to make sure that your email doesn't end up in the dreaded spam folder. Bum, bum, bum. Now, before I begin, let me just caveat this. I feel like I'm always caveating things, but I know like in the comments down below, people go, Ravi, you're wrong. Let me caveat this by saying that it is impossible to make sure that every single email you send out never lands in the spam folder. Spam regulations are tighter now than they ever have been in the past, but there are a few techniques that you can use, that we use, that we teach inside Scaling With Systems to make sure that the majority of the time, which is more than most people, your email lands in the main inbox of your end user. So without further ado, let's dive right into it. The number one tip, the first way that I'm gonna tell you that you can keep your email from hitting into the old spam bam is a unique subject line. And I know what you're thinking, Ravi, what the heck do you mean by unique? And no, I'm not talking about what your mom tells you when you come home for Thanksgiving and you know you don't have a job and you're still sleeping on the couch and she's like, honey, you're so unique. And you're like, thanks, mom. That's not the type of unique I'm talking about. Check out the screenshot that I'm gonna put up here of literally the inside of my spam folder, my email inbox that I just took a few moments ago. And I wanna show you, if you look at the subject line of some of these emails, you can see they're all caps, or there's probably like 6 or 7 exclamation points, or there's a bunch of emojis, or they use words like free or guaranteed or money or any of that. These are all telltale signs that your email is a spam email and it's gonna go into the spam folders. Because think, when was the last time you sent an email to somebody in all caps or a subject line or with 10 exclamation points or with 6 or 7 different emojis on it? Unless you were really angry at them or you're sending some kind of weird email, there's a good chance you've never sent an email with a subject line like that. So for your cold or even warm messaging like you do to your newsletters, make sure you use a subject line that is unique. You know, add some kind of personalization inside of it. Ask a question, invoke curiosity, and for the love of all things holy, keep it short. Some great ones that we've used inside of Scaling With Systems and things that we teach our clients are things such as a quick question, or is this still your address, or thought this would be useful for you. Those things are not spammy, they're not lying, and it invokes curiosity enough so that the end user, my lead, is gonna probably click on that and open it and see what the next words I have in that email are gonna be. Tip number two is to clean out your email list, okay? More often than not, I don't care if you scraped thousands or hundreds of thousands, or we know some people inside Scaling With Systems that have email lists of millions of people, or if you have an inbound email list that people have opted into your stuff over the past few years, you're gonna have invalid emails. You're gonna have old email addresses that don't work anymore, and when you send an email to them, they do what's known as bounce, or they come back at you. This is another great example of how these email providers look at something as spam, right? When was the last time you personally sent an email to somebody that you know and it bounced back? Almost never, right? Or once in a blue moon. But if you have an email list of 1,000 people and you send it out, and even let's just say 100 of those 1,000 aren't still valid right now, well, it's gonna know, those email providers are gonna know that you're a spammer because you have 100 bounce backs all in a short amount of time, and they're gonna make it so all of your emails go into spam for all of your potential leads that you're trying to talk to. Inside Scaling With Systems, we literally have our clients using our virtual assistants to send anywhere from 3,000 to 5,000 emails every single day. So it's critically important that we make sure that email list is clean when they're sending those out so that they can hit that deliverability of 80 to 90% in the end user inbox that once again leads to more opens, more responses, more appointments, more meetings, more sales in your pocket. So after you've gathered your list of emails, whether it's through an automated software, it's inbound leads, or you've manually scraped them yourself, make sure you take them through some kind of software such as like Neverbounce, where you can just drop the whole list inside of there, it scrubs them, finds all the invalid ones, pulls them out, and spits out a brand new, fresh, shiny, clean email list. Tip number three for making sure that your email lands in the inbox of your end user is to make sure that the email body, the main content of the email, is not spammy. Just like the subject line, most email service providers are looking for words inside of an email copy that just scream spammer. You know, words like free in all capital, or money back guarantee, or get this now, or get this for free now, or wire money, or any one of these things. Your email service providers are going to be looking for those that are going to make it seem like this is a spammy email, and thus put it in the spam folder and save your end user the horror of having to read your poorly written email. Make sure you have your emails as personalized as humanly possible, right? So add stuff like first names inside of there, maybe cities that these leads are going to be in, maybe job titles that they're at, companies that they work for, and you can trickle them throughout the email copy, so that it looks more personalized, looks more like you handwritten that letter rather than sending the same email to 5,000 people in one day. One of our favorite things to do inside Scaling with Systems, something we teach our clients, to say something like, hey, I noticed that you were a real estate agent in Atlanta, Georgia, and I wanted to reach out. In that instance, it may seem like we know that person individually and it seems like it's more personalized, but in reality, we probably manually scraped a list of realtors in Atlanta, Georgia, and so we didn't really do any personalization, but in the eyes of the end user and in the eyes of the email service providers, we did. And finally, tip number four is honestly more of a requirement than it is a tip. Not too long ago in the United States, there was an act passed called the CAN-SPAM Act, which essentially prevented people such as maybe you or maybe even me from consistently abusing cold email systems and abusing businesses and end consumers with our messaging with zero repercussions. I know what you're thinking, Ravi, well, why should I care? It's just some kind of act that doesn't have any effect on me. Well, it depends on how much you like $40,000, because if you don't follow what I'm about to tell you next, it could cost you up to $40,000 for every single email that you're sending that doesn't follow these rules. If you're sending a few thousand emails a day, like a lot of us are doing, then that could end up being a lot of cheddar. I suggest, as usual, that you do a quick little Google search and look up what CAN-SPAM Act is so you know that you're protected. But one of the things that is probably the most important that I see most people not doing, and that I haven't already covered this video, is make sure you include a signature with your full name, your business's full name, and the business address. I know what you're thinking, Ravi, I don't want to put my physical address on this email. Well, that's fine, as long as you're okay potentially being fined up to $40,000. And the other quick little tip inside of the CAN-SPAM Act is make sure you give your end user an easy way to opt out of your email. So if you're using a major email provider where you're like sending out a bunch of emails from a different software, more likely than not, they're going to have an unsubscribe button. But if you're going to use something else, just make sure that you give some way for that email user, that end user, to unsubscribe from your emails so that they're not locked into doing it and then you end up with a fat little fine. So there you have it, an in-depth guide on how to make sure your emails don't land in the spam folder and lead you to more opens, more responses, more appointments, and more sales for your company. So now you know how to make sure you don't end up in the email spam folder, but do you know what you should be exactly saying in the messaging? Do you know how to make it so that you're consistently generating leads across multiple platforms? And then what even happens when you get a response from somebody? Do you know how to turn that into a sale? I wanna invite you guys really quickly to click the link in the description below. I shot a free training the other day where I walk you through the exact steps that I use to scale both of my companies to seven figures. And we go really in depth on the whole concept of lead generation, what softwares we use, what platforms we use, and what's the scripts and messaging we use in order to generate consistent appointments every single day. So be sure to click the link in my description and get access to that now. Be sure to also like, subscribe, turn on the bell notifications, and comment down below and let me know if you have any other questions about email sending, spam folders, how to stay out of them, email copy, or the CAN-SPAM laws or anything like that. And I'm gonna personally go in and respond back to each and every one of those. Thank you guys so much for watching the video, and I'll check you guys in the next one.